The anti-friction bearing, first of all, we're going to learn how the numbering of the bearing is done, how the, you have to select the different numbers. So basically number is given in the form of four digits. Here the first number relates to the bearing type, second number relates to the bearing series, and the third and fourth represents the size of the bore. So if the first number appears as a 6, then you can conclude that it is a deep groove ball bearing. If first number is 7, then we have a roller bearing. And instead of that, if the series start with 4, then you get like deep groove. So first number either 6, 7, 4, detailed list is available in the handbooks. It is 7001, it means that it is a roller bearing. And if it is a 4001, it means that it is a deep groove double row bearing. The second number relates bearing series, which reflects the robustness of the bearing. That is, the bearing is light or medium or heavy duty or for thin sections. So 0 is for extra light, 9 for thin section, 3 for medium and 4 for heavy. And the last two number are basically the bores. But first four number are the standard numbers. That is 00 to 03, they are designated bore size depending upon the number. Say for 00, we have 10 mm bore, 01 is 12 mm, 02 is 15 mm and 03 is 17 mm. And after that, any number will come, you have to simply multiply by 5. So while the number over 3 simply have bore size which is 5 times that of the 3rd and 4th digit. So let's say for example we have 60, suppose 6003, it means that it is a deep groove ball bearing and the diameter will be equals to 17 mm. That is a bore equal to 17 mm. And 0 stands for extra light duty. 00 is 10, 01 is 12, 02 is 15, 03 is 17. After that you have to multiply by 5. Suppose we have 6309, it means that it is a deep groove ball bearing because 6 number appears. 3 means it is used for medium duty, and 09 you have to multiply by 5, so the bore size is 45 mm. Suppose we have number 7012, so first number 7 stands for it is a roller bearing, it is used for light duty, and 12 is to be multiplied by 5, so the bore size will be equal to 60 mm. Now let's define few term more. One is rating life, then L10 and L50 life. Rating life, it is the number of revolutions completed by the bearing before its failure, and life under reliability is given by the available distribution. So in that case we have two lives, one is called as L10 life and L50 life. So suppose we take a sample of 100 bearings and we test them, and if 90% of them will survive for the given life, then it is called as L10 life, and if the 50% of them survive, then it will be called as L50 life. So suppose we have a sample of 100 bearing and we are expecting a life of 100 million revolutions, and out of 100, if the 90%, that is 90 bearing, will successfully pass the test of 100 million revolution, then it is said that L10 life. So the failure is only 10%. Similarly, same definition hold for L50 life. The only difference is that the average life for which 50% of the bearing will not survive, and the average life is approximately 5 times as long as L10 life in L50. So normally we are using a L10 life concept. The company will give the data for L10 life. So in the case of L10, 90% of the bearing would achieve the successfully rated load, that is decided by the company. So company will give the data for that. Then you have to design your load capacity, and then you have to select the bearing. The company will not going to design as per your requirement, but to select the bearing from your company catalog. So you must able to calculate the L10 value and your load. So some formulas are available for this one. How you can calculate L10? L10 can be calculated as 60 multiplied by capital N multiplied by LH divided by 10 to the power 6, where N is RPM and LH is the life of bearing in express in hours, and divided by 10 to the power 6, the answer will come in millions of revolution. That is how we can calculate L10. It is always expressed in millions of revolution. Say for example, if you have LH equal to 2000 hours and you are running the bearing at a speed of 4000 RPM, then we can calculate L10, how many revolutions it will survive. So it is 60 multiplied by 4000 multiplied by 2000, divided by 10 to the power 6. So this is called as millions of revolution. So this answer is 480 millions of revolution. Then we can, company will decide the basic load. C will be the basic load and P is your radial load. So L10 is equal to C by P to the power A, where C is called as dynamic and P is called as radial load. Out of that, the company has decided the C load, so that is a constant value, and the radial load or equivalent load that you have to calculate. Value of A depends what type of bearing we are using. A is equal to 3 for ball bearing and A is equal to 10 by 3 for roller bearing. Remember this equation, gate will always ask you a question based on this one. And suppose we have two types of bearing, that is A and B, and if we take a ratio, we will get PB by PA divided by to the power A, because the C dynamic load is get cancelled in both the equations. So here C is the basic load or a constant value that is normally available in catalog for the corresponding bearing number. And if you take a ratio of two different loads, then your basic load remains constant. So life is inversely proportional to the load to the power A. Say the load is doubled, it means that the life will become 1 by 8 if it is a ball bearing. So important criteria is L10 life, which is given as C divided by P to the power A. Now P is here equivalent load or a variable load. It can be FR or it can be FA or it can be addition of FR plus FA. So you have a separate procedure to calculate the equivalent load, but it can accept any value. Then one more important term is basic load rating of ball bearing is the radial load at which 90% of the group of apparently identical run for 1 million revolution, that is called as L10 life. So this is called as basic load. So company will guarantee for 90% of bearing will survive for 1 million revolution. Say for example, we have L10 equal to 480 millions of revolutions and the corresponding radial load is 20 kilonewton. And let us assume that we are using a ball bearing. So we have A equal to 3. Now suppose the load is going to be doubled, that equal to 40 kilonewton. Then we want to calculate what is the expected life in that situation if the load is doubled. So this time we use the same this formula, which is basically L10 C by AP to the power A formula. So if you take the ratio, your C value is get cancelled because it is a basic load. And we have L10 A, which is equal to 480 divided by L10 B that we don't know. We have load change equal to 40 kilo and initial load was 20 to the power A. A is for ball bearing is 3. So from this we can calculate L10 B. So L10 B come out to be 60 millions revolution. It means that the load is doubled, then your answer will reduce by 1 by 8. So always remember, if the load is doubled, then you have to just take the power 3 and your that answer will be get reduced by that factor. If you make it 3 times, then 3 by 3 will be 27. So just by comparison to the two loads, we can compare this value of the life in millions of revolution. So to remember, you have to remember two formula. One is L10 and one is L10 equal to C by P to the power A. The given bearing has the same basic load as per the company, so the value of C will not change. Depending upon the operating condition, radial and axial load may change. Hence, we require the equivalent load, calculation of equivalent load. So equivalent load can be calculated as combined axial and radial loads. So FA indicates axial, FR indicates radial, and FA represents equivalent load. Then we can have the equivalent radial load, which is defined as the load that has the same damage and combined radial and axial thrust. So we can, it is defined in the form of VXY. You have to take the V value is equal to 1 for inner race rotating and 1.2 for race rotating. X is equal to radial factor and Y is equal to axial factor. You can obtain the value of X and Y from the chart. So very few questions are expected, or almost no questions are expected on this side in gate examination. So we have equivalent load is equal to X multiplied by V multiplied by the radial load plus Y multiplied by FA, that is the axial load. And here you have to select the value of X and Y from the graph. And V is the race factor or the rotation factor. As far as the thrust bearing is considered, they normally take only the axial load, and radial load for them is zero. Hence, for thrust bearing, since the radial load equal to zero, the value of x will be equals to zero and y will be equals to one. Whereas for cylindrical type of bearing, which only accept or subjected to radial load, so we have radial load only and axial load will be equal to zero. In that case, y will be zero, the value of x equal to one, and the value of v have to select. So as far as you are concerned, remember L10 formula. Then you also remember L10 in terms of C by P formula and the comparison of two loads. So that is the only important part for this one. Then one number you have to remember is Sommerfeld number, which is R by C whole square mu n by P. And the basic calculations for Newton's law of viscosity you should know. So these are the only requirements for this chapter.